All right, as we continue with the service, the proclamation for this week is taken from Ephesians chapter 4, verses 7, 11 to 16. Ephesians 4, 7, then we jump to verses 11 to 16. Again, it has been personalized so that it will reflect what God has already promised us by claiming it and also by applying them to our lives, and also to declare to God so that our soul will be encouraged in what God has said about us and what we also believe and know. Just in the same way we sing our hymns, we know that God has provided the writers to declare a lot of promises for us. So here is another version of proclaiming, but we are using the scriptures and only personalizing it. Somebody may say modify, but it's only to personalize it to ourselves in the same way that we read the Lord is my shepherd. So if we can say that, then it means that we can apply the same personal blessing upon our soul, upon our life. So let us declare, oh my gracious, my most gracious, merciful, heavenly, holy Father, and Jehovah Shalom, the Lord my peace. Through your abundant love, you have given to each one of us grace according to the measure of Christ's gift. It was you, my El Shaddai, the Lord God Almighty, who gave some of us apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, and some pastors and teachers for the equipping of your saints for the work of ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ, till I come to the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God, to a perfect Christian, to the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ, that I should no longer be a child, tossed to and fro and carried about with every wind of doctrine by the trickery of men and women in the cunning craftiness of deceitful plotting, but speaking the truth in love, may grow up in all things into him who is the head, my blessed Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, from whom the whole body, joined and knit together by what every joint supplies, according to the effective working by which every part does its share, causes growth of the body for the edifying of itself in love. Thank you, Holy Father, for this covenant. I humble myself before your throne of grace, trusting that your Holy Spirit will continue to remind me of these promises, to receive and apply them because of my union with your begotten Son through his atoning blood sacrifice, which he shed for me on Calvary's cross. And I pray in faith with thanksgiving for answering my request in the blessed name of my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Ephesians 4, verse 7, and then verses 11 to 16. Amen. We may be seated.